So, rural hazard. Bends, lanes. How do you think we are with that? Have we achieved it? Have we exceeded
Definitely
it?
Definitely got a lot better at that, I reckon, yeah.
Overtaking in progress?
We haven't really done that yet.
We tried to do an overtake, but it's impossible when you're travelling at the speed limit. Progress, how do you think you're doing there?
I made quite a bit of progress, especially with the new techniques.
Okay. Observation skills, middle and far distance?
Yeah. Distance has been good.
Cool. Dual carriageways and motorways, similar things, aren't they?
Yeah.
Joining, turning, leaving? We've done a bit of that.
Done a bit of that.
Forward planning and observation?
Yep. About the leaving and things, yeah.
Overtaking?
Done that.
Yep. How about that? Same things on the motorways?
Yeah.
The only thing we haven't covered is breakdowns and safety procedures. If you broke down on the motorway, what would you do?
Go into the hard shoulder.
Okay.
Call for assistance. And wait in your car.
Okay. Would you wait in the car or would you get out?
I would probably say, if it's safe to do so, get out.
Yeah. Climb over the barrier and stay out there. Reason being that people run into that lane sometimes at 70 miles an hour. That's fine. I'll look at that. So, all-weather driving we can't really do much with. Night driving we'll do tomorrow night.
Yeah.
But looking at parking, what difference does it make on a nighttime parking? Where should you park, do you think?
Under somewhere that's lit, preferably. Yeah. So
if you can't do that,
then park in somewhere that might be a little bit busier.
Possibly. So let's assume that you live on a long straight road. It's a little bit countryfied, and you're going to park your car outside. Which direction would you face? With the flow of traffic or against?
I would say, with.
Okay, cool. And would you put any sort of lights on?
Might be good to put some parking lights on.
Any idea how you do that?
Don't know if I'd be sure
so
on this.
The light switch is down there on the right, so you can put your side lights on.
Yeah, side lights.
Is there another way you can do that? Parking lights? So if you're facing with the flow of traffic.
Yeah.
Put your indicator on with everything off, that'll put that side side light on. That one puts that side light on. So you can light up the front and the back at that side.
Okay.
Just by using the indicators without the power on. Back to the motorway thing, if you've broken down, obviously you might be able to use your mobile phone for assistance, but if your mobile's got no signal?
There will be phones along and you'll be able to see which one's nearest to you and what's the nearest one, and there'll be directions, won't there?
Okay. How can you tell which one's nearest to you?
It's directions on the barrier, is it?
There is. Yeah. It's on the posts.
Yeah.
The marker post that tells you which one's the closest. If you've broken and it's not something that's seizing your wheels up and stuff, you could just let it freewheel up to the nearest phone.
Yeah.
You know, turn the engine off, let it run in. But further than that, just get it. Most important thing is to stop safely.
Yeah.
Okay, so I mean, I think we've got a lot of, you know, the bigger book I gave you.
Yeah.
Have a look in there and just see which ones you think you can tick off, and then we'll have a discussion about that.
Yeah.
I mean, obviously, it matters what I think of signing them off, but it matters what you think in terms of development, really.
Yeah.
So we'll do a little bit more town driving and stuff, we'll do a little bit of country driving on the way out. And then nighttime driving tomorrow, that should see us about right, I think.
Okay.
When you're ready, off you blooming well go. So you've probably noticed I'm slightly different at work than what I am at band.
Yeah.
This is serious business. Off you go when you're ready.
Do you reckon that'd be the friends?
Sure, we're finding out. No.
It's not enough revs.
It was. What's happened there is this is a Ford thing.
Right.
It jumped at a reverse.
Right, I see.
So it'll go in, but if you take it back at a reverse, lift the clutch up and down again, and then put it back into reverse, you'll find it'll clunk in this time.
What with?
Yep, what? So if you put the clutch back down and put it back into reverse.
Yeah.
you feel that was more solid as it went in. Sometimes they don't go in. It'll go sort of half in. It's happened to me a few times. And Phil, one of the guys that works here, he's got the Fiesta, his does the same. So I think it's a little bit of a design flaw. Either that or I'm a rubbish driver. Caught it at the same time I caught it, so hold on. Out of the car park and turn right, please. Some of that lovely forward planning skills into practice as we go along this way. Mebbies.
That's the plan.
You have to get used to saying mebbies if you're going to live in your car.
Yeah, I know.
Aye, maybe.
Mebbies.
Mebbies. You sorted out where you're going to live? Or is that a little early for that?
No. I have, I think. There's a new place been built.
Ah, right.
I think it's called Park Terrace.
Oh, right.
So it's
next
not
to St. James's.
It's not even, yeah. I don't even think it's properly built yet, though. But we'll have to see about that. I think it's Park Terrace, or is that one that has been built? The one I wanted to go to anyway, it wasn't finished.
Leisure's Terrace, which at the moment I think was Leisure's Park Terrace. People used to sit on the roofs of the houses there and watch the football, you can't they?
Yeah, my the accountancy rooms overlook the stadium, but they're not quite high enough to see in.
Right.
Even on the top floor, you can't quite see in.
Right.
But you get reduced fees, apparently, for matches. If you're a student.
It's a lovely stadium.
Yeah, it is, yeah.
Passionate fans, kind of like it. We go left at the end of the road, at the second set of travel lanes, towards Nottingley. you guys share a lifter van, don't you, sometimes? Or do you all do carpool? Or?
Oh, me and Neil Day and that lot. Yeah. We have me, Neil Day, Ryan comes. Sometimes Matt comes as well. It's mostly just me, Neil, and Ryan. Share it. It's quite good, really.
Yeah, it's nice to have come there. But that was another plus point I got to do with the car share thing, because IMSA was travelling on my own.
Yeah.
But at least now every other band I get the chance of, I'll be able to follow the road ahead.
Do you always go to the pub after then, or?
Most times, yeah. That's part of the sort. I mean, because my other half's living and working in Blackpool at the minute, so that's
right.
A bit of company, if not else.
Yeah.
It's good crack sometimes as well.
What's she doing over there?
She's a consultant radiologist.
It's a bit highbrow.
Mm. Maybe for a bloke like me. Is that what you meant?
No. She's American, isn't she?
She is. Well, American stroke German. So German parents were born in America.
Exotic.
It's an interesting mix. Things there, though, isn't it? You're actually faced with a choice.
Yeah.
You can carry on with the speed you were going and end up really annoyed with them for pulling out when you were close. Or you can do what you did and thought, you're coming anyway.
Yeah.
And just ease back up the notch.
You're gonna come out, aren't you?
And then you're not in a sort of. And it can ruin your day.
Mm.
You know, if you get several people like that, if you're driving for a living and for the first hour of your day it's full of people pulling out in front of you, you can end up on the ceiling and it's just not good for you. Continue a little chat. You broke down on the motorway.
Yeah.
Would you put a warning triangle in? And if you would, where would you put it?
Yeah, probably about a good 100 metres behind your car.
Okay.
I'd say.
And if that was, say, on a dual carriageway?
And there wasn't a hard shoulder at all?
Yeah.
Or if there wasn't a hard shoulder, probably.
Sometimes it's just making the best of what you've got, isn't it?
Yeah, it depends how busy it is. Best thing to do is just get out of the way of it then.
Well, I once broke down on the North Circular in London.
Oh, gosh.
At a busy town. And to leave the car on the road was causing chaos.
Yeah.
And it was a fairly wide path, so I bumped it up on the path, which you shouldn't do, but it was the lesser of two evils.
Yeah.
We're actually creating a danger by creating the traffic here. Signs towards Ferry Bridge, please. I mean, we might get the chance to do a, if you're doing the car share thing and you're at band and it turns out it's raining heavily, we could maybe step out and do it. If we get the opportunity, if not, we'll just have a chat about it.
The only thing is, all the people getting home. Car sharing.
I mean, if you're in Neil's car.
Oh, if I'm in Neil's car,
you just drive yourself up in this car.
Mm. Yeah.
We can be flexible.
Yeah, okay.
So is this how you drive normally, or have you put a special show on just for me?
A bit of both, really.
Okay.
It depends. But I guess I'm driving how I did when I was learning.
Okay.
Because I'm in the same car as I'm learning, and it's a manual, like I'm learning. And I've only actually driven kind of on my own in an automatic. generally know where I'm going as well, which helps.
That could be a big help.
Yeah.
It could also be a bit of a problem, can it? Well, if you get over familiar,
yeah.
It could create maybe complacency.
Yeah.
Fast driving's okay. Fast driving here would be suicide for somebody.
Yeah. Are they allowed to park all the way down here?
Yeah, it's, well, they've got nowhere else to park, have they?
Well,
it does make life awkward. This place was built before people had this many cars.
Yeah.
But I do get a bit of fun out of sometimes. Sometimes I'll leave the L plate on the top. I'm floating around in North Yorkshire. Right. Sometimes I get some boy racers coming up behind and stuff, and I do sometimes just absolutely leave them for dead. They catch me up on the straights, but they kind of get near me on the bends.
Yeah.
So I've got the car balanced. It's great fun. And it really, really winds them up. Being burnt off by
a learning driver.
A learning driver. See, what are the lines telling you here?
They're quite close together, so you know.
Yeah, it's a trundler boat. What could you do to increase your fun level here?
Overtake?
Possibly. Have you got an opportunity to do that?
No.
If I'm out for fun, I might even park up for a minute or two.
Yeah.
Get rid of them. If I can't get past them. And then I've opened the road up for me to play on. I might slow right down and just let them get ahead of me. Because they're spoiling me fun. We can start investigating that. You can see that hedge against the one at the other side. Opening up. So you can just start getting, even when other people are driving, you can start looking at it and thinking, oh yeah, I can see that's opening up. I would have put the gas on now. I wouldn't have put the gas on yet. So if you look here, the telegraph pole against this edge, well, that's opening out already, isn't it? So you know that this isn't tight. You obviously just know that technique.
It's not been taught.
But you have got rid of them. Frog spawny down here, doesn't it?
It does, yes. It's not the best.
This is where it becomes a problem because you haven't got the hedges to measure.
Yeah. No idea. At least there's a line in the middle of the road, though.
Yes.
There's a lot of places in Lincolnshire where there isn't.
So what that can tell you something as well. If there's no pin on the road, what does that generally indicate?
It's not actually really wide enough for two cars all the time.
So we generally say the more pin there is, the more hazard.
Yeah.
But the exception of that is when there's no pin, that's probably quite a big hazard.
See, that's not really wide enough.
Adjusted accordingly, which is good. Like I said, nothing wrong with speed in the right hands on the right place. Just as I came off the bend,
yeah,
and bang, and really gone for it. But once you get this far along, it's like,
Maybe not.
But there's also all sorts of things can help as you're looking further ahead on the road. You know, if you look ahead, you see hedge, and it gets a bend one way or the other. But which way does the hedge go? That might be a long, straight follow-up. So you can start hunting those opportunities. In the winter time, this low down, what do you think might be a hazard here?
Snow.
Maybe
ice.
Yeah, close to water too, and low down it can
flood.
Can have an effect, yeah. So again, as you look at the bend ahead, does it look like it opens up a bit?
Yeah, it does.
You've kind of got that happening, the gaps are getting wider. There might be an opportunity to overtake, there might not. But it's a possibility. So if that possibility is there, you may think about nudging a little closer to it and thinking, can I not? What do you reckon?
I'd say
yeah, you go. Easy peasy. And that's the approach to take. Bang! Gas! It's a good feeling, that, isn't it? When you've hunted down an overtaking manoeuvre and it comes off. Yeah. I would have done exactly the same there. He made me feel very uncomfortable when he came up there. His indicator was on, but his speed said he wasn't turning.
Yeah, it did. Oh, may as well wait, really.
Yeah, the consequences of that going wrong were bad for you.
Yes.
If he had come hurling towards you, what could you have done there, do you think? Where was your escape route?
To the left.
Yeah. Well, you're indicating that way, we were around the other side of
him. Yeah.
It's like, you know, if this car coming towards you loses control and it comes towards you, where do you think the safest place to go is?
Probably the right, but...
Yeah, where he came from, because he's no longer there.
You know, at a crossroads, there's two lines of traffic coming from opposite each other, and then there's the other sides that are both on red light.
Yeah.
And you're going, you want to turn right.
Yeah.
Do you go behind the other drivers or...
Well, this is technically that's what we're telling you you should do, isn't it? Well,
cars
have you ever had anybody let you do that?
No.
So everybody goes front to front.
Yeah.
That's how everybody does it. So you're not faced with a choice. But ideally, I mean, do you know what the issue is with going front to front like that?
Well, if you decide not to go, if someone's just left their indicator on, then and you start going, I guess then you're going to turn it to them.
It's also limiting your view as well, isn't it?
Yeah.
But it's just, again, it's, you know, making the best of what you've got.
Yeah.
But nobody will let you go around each other like that. They just won't do it. So I'm afraid you've got to go with the herd. Not ideal, but there it is. So what time does Alan normally leave for band?
Seven, I'd say. Yeah, okay. Seven.
So if I picked you up maybe a little bit earlier, so we're going to have a little bit of quarter down, is that all right?
Yeah, sign in.
Half decent goalkeeper at one time.
actually say Garforth this way, actually.
Oh, yeah, we can go this way. We get the roundabout, we kind of double the back of it. Signs were telling you that it was a tight bend, but you worked out it wasn't.
Yeah. I think this was the right way, actually.
I think you can go either way.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
This curry house any good still? It used to be really good in here at one
time. I've not been, actually.
Really good. But that's a few years ago then.
Yeah.
Well, so it's further up than there's at the Agra, that they call it. Very nice. Seeing how to drink.
That's
all I'm sure you already know how to drink.
Right, let's see here. We get to the car garage, turn left, that's it.
I'll let you lead the way. That's the one that goes over that weird bridge, isn't it?
Yeah. Yeah, exactly. Forgot I had a clutch then.
You remember in time, that's the main thing. Automatics are great, but they make you lazy, don't they?
Oh, they do, yeah. Very. It's not the best thing when you first pass through that.
That's it, once you're in, you're in. There's nothing else to be done but to go. And all the other people coming the other way are going to be sensible about it, which they were. The Podger, what a great name for a pub. Golf yet then, or not?
I've been to the driving range. Quite like it.
Yeah.
I had lessons when I was younger. But
it's a game that can really mess with your head, yeah. That's the only thing. Really mess with your head. I started to get stupidly competitive and it really ruined it for me.
What did you play on?
18 at one time.
It's alright, isn't it, really?
It's not too bad. Not brilliant, but kind of okay.
The Callum's about 14 now.
14?
Yeah.
He's a tiny player. Laura's strikes the ball well.
Laura's 4 now.
4? Oh. Jeez. That's scary, isn't it?
No. She
messing about with them speed humps, are they?
As well.
One more to go.
Oh, exactly.
Excellent, well done.
Not too bad.
We'll continue the good work tomorrow. I'll get off. Thank you very much. So, enjoy it?
Yeah, okay. Yeah, very good actually.
Useful?
Yeah.
Some new stuff to perhaps play with, do you think?
Yeah.
Excellent.
Try out.
Well, I'll let you go and watch some movies, and I'll see you tomorrow night.
Yes.